Day especially, books are a great gift to give, but they're also wonderful to give to kids for the holidays. But finding the perfect read for your child isn't always easy. Barb Langridge is here from the Howard County Library with some great ideas. This week we're talking boys. Next week we're going to talk girls. You actually have a personality test that parents can take to find out what their kids like to read.
Yes, which reading superhero are you? If you go on A Book and a Hug, way up at the tippity top in tiny little letters, it says, which reading superhero are you? They take 10 questions and they figure out what kind of reader they are. And then on the website, we've taken the books and we've slotted them in so that they can find just the book that'll resonate with them. Now, you guys know you walk into a bookstore or a library and you're trying to figure out, well, gee, you know, what do I want as an adult? Well, kids are the same way. If you've got two kids, you know they're completely different. First book I'm going to kick off with is called Ungifted. This is going to be for what I call a belonger connector. This is a guy who's traditional. This is a guy who likes to belong to things. He likes to invest in a team, school, his family. In this story, you've got a kid who is called Reckless and has absolutely no impulse control. Okay? Now, he is hardly your candidate for the gifted and talented program. That's exactly where he's going to end up.
Okay.
All right? So it's funny, and these guys really do like funny, but they also like, you know, hey, what's going on with that guy?
Right. Try to figure it out.
Exactly. The same kind of guy is going to love sports books. So Mike Lupica is wonderful. This is Game Changers. You've got Ben. He's about 11 years old. He's like a Doug Flutie guy. Okay. He's like, you know, a little guy. And so when he wants to go out for the quarterback position on the team, he's up against the big guy. He's also up against the coach's son. Who do you think gets the quarterback role?
Of course.
Okay,
yeah.
But a lot of stuff starts happening there. And the Belonger Connector guys like to read about that. They like to see what goes on the team. All right, now, we're going to kick over completely to the warrior's heart. This is the guy I call seeker leader. This is less of our population. This is like about 12%. But this is the guy who wants to know, what does it mean to be a great man? What can I do to make a difference in the world? Okay, in the warrior's heart, this is a true story about a guy who decided to become a Navy SEAL. Now, he went from Rhodes Scholar to Navy SEAL. What is it like to go through Navy SEAL training? What is it like to be a SEAL? That's that guy's kind of thing.
To get kids to read nonfiction can be very difficult, too.
Absolutely. So. Well, except for the last guy.
Okay.
In a Glass Grimly. This is jokester, thrill-seeking party animal. Big part of the male population.
Exactly.
You guys know him
if
you've got him.
The class clown is going to love this.
Yes. He likes humor. He likes anything intense, scary, thrilling. We're talking fairy tale, but this is not la-la fairy tale. This is blood, vomit, and naked people, okay?
Wow. All right. Naked people, is that appropriate?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
We must have naked people.
Okay.
What is life without it? Okay, Steve Sheinkin is for our last guy. This is what the guy I call Answer Man. Now, this is the bomb. Answer Man likes information, but he also challenges. Parents out there who have Answer Man, they know.
Right.
Every time they tell him something, it's like, well, prove it to me. He's going to test it, you know, check, you know, decide for himself. In The Bomb, this is the story of the atomic bomb. These are the scientists and the spies. And it opens up in May 1950 with a guy who has spent 17 years spying on the American scientists. And now he's trying to hide all the evidence before the FBI comes in. Really, anybody would love this one.
Great.
But it's perfect for Answer Man.
So these are your picks for today, but you can go on the website. You can find many other ideas.
Yes.
And a book and a hug.
And if, you know, if they have a question, they're not sure about their child, they can email me, and I would be more than happy to do personal book recommendations.
That's great. Next week, we're talking girls.
We're talking the girls.
Okay, but you can take the personality quiz now if you'd like to.
Absolutely.
To get ready for next week.
There
All right,
go.
Barb, thank you so much. You can find more of these books and Barb's reading personalities on her website. It's a bookandahug.com. You don't want to miss it. Stay with us. The Humane Society joins